I'm Dr. John Iskander. Welcome to Beyond the Data. I'm here today with Dr. Lauri Hicks, Medical Director of CDC's Get Smart, Know When Antibiotics Work program. So Lauri, at this week's Grand Rounds, we heard about the problem of excessive and inappropriate antibiotic use. What should people take home about that issue in big picture terms?
Well, we know that in outpatient settings, about 258 million courses of antibiotics are used each year. And if you think about that, that's enough antibiotics for 4 out of every 5 Americans. That's just an incredible amount of antibiotic use just in the outpatient setting. And we believe that about 50% of all antibiotic use, whether it's in hospitals or outpatient settings, is unnecessary or inappropriate.
That's really quite remarkable. Now, one thing we didn't have time to talk about during the session, but which I know is of interest to a lot of people, is antibiotic use in animals on the farm, so to speak. What should people know about the science behind that issue, and how concerned should they be?
Well, there's no question that animal antibiotic use has an impact on human health. And I think about it as antibiotic use anywhere is antibiotic use everywhere. We have seen outbreaks of infectious diseases in humans that have been acquired through our food supply. And so we definitely need to work to improve animal antibiotic use. The question is, okay, where can we make improvements? We know that antibiotics are still needed to treat infections in animals, but there is a lot of antibiotic use for growth promotion for animals. And so we support FDA's efforts to eliminate that practice.
Okay. So coming back to, again, the more typical setting where our audience might deal with antibiotics, what should physicians and others who prescribe antibiotics, what should their actions be right now to better use antibiotics?
Well, we know that providers are under a lot of time pressures in their offices and in the hospital to prescribe appropriately. But we do want them to take a step back and think about what are the guidelines for appropriate prescribing. There's lots of guidance out there to improve prescribing. The first thing we want providers to ask themselves, okay, does this patient have a bacterial infection? So determine the likelihood of a bacterial infection. Second question they should be thinking about, okay, what are the harms and the benefits of prescribing this antibiotic, and weighing the risks and benefits. We know that antibiotics are not harmless medications. And then finally, when an antibiotic is needed, we want providers to prescribe the right drug at the right dose and for the right duration. So those three steps, I want providers to be thinking about those three steps every time they're thinking about prescribing.
Okay, very, very useful. Now, on the other side of the prescribing pad, patients and parents of children, what should they do to educate themselves? What are the actions that they can take as patients to help us all better use antibiotics?
Yeah, it's without question that parents and patients play a role in this problem, and we need parents and patients to help us improve antibiotic use. And one thing I need parents and patients to think about when they're going to their providers is that antibiotics don't work to treat viruses. They only work to treat bacterial infections. So things like colds, flu, lots of the coughs this time of year actually won't respond to antibiotic therapy. We want the parents and patients to go to the providers and ask, what's the best treatment for my child's illness? If a parent or patient demands an antibiotic, they're much more likely to get one, even if it's not needed.
We used to say at the state level, sometimes the best medicine is no medicine.
Absolutely. So we often say, wait and see. If there is no indication that an antibiotic is needed, wait and see may be the best approach.
So are there any concluding points that our audience, perhaps those working in the public health setting, that they should be armed with to be able to, do their work better in promoting antibiotic use or to educate their families and their communities? What are some take-homes for public health practitioners?
Well, I definitely feel like the public health practitioners play a role in this as well, and we must engage state and local health departments when we're thinking about improving antibiotic use in the community. And so we really need to work with our state and local health department partners to get the messages out there. One thing we do every year is we have an observance, Get Smart About Antibiotics Week, and we partner with our state and local health department partners. We give them messages to disseminate to providers and the general public. So we will ask our partners to work with the messages that we're providing and disseminate them through various channels, whether professional societies or their local partners, to get the messages out to the general public and providers.
Okay, so important actions that can be taken by those who prescribe antibiotics, mm-hmm. by those who take or don't take antibiotics, mm-hmm. and by those who work in public health to promote better antibiotic use, to better conserve this precious resource for all of us. Thank you very much, Dr. Hicks. Thank you for joining us for CDC's Beyond the Data. Please join us again next month.